Morning and welcome to another day of the video diary, documentary, whatever you want to call it, or episode. I'm your host, Simon Paul, and we just left Rugeley Town. I thought it's better off to do the intro in here than out there, because you probably may not be able to hear me because it might be windy. But we're going to, well, since we've been to Manchester the last one, I thought today, you know what? Liverpool. So we're going to have a day there in Liverpool. Going to be there for about 9 o'clock in the morning as soon as I arrive to 17:37 back to Stafford and then on to Rugeley that way. Today will be involved Merseyrail Class 5 and 7 and 8. We're going to fill out a few stations. I don't know where I'm going to fill, to be honest, but I know I've got the first one planned already, which will be Sandhills. Then I might go on to the Wirral Line. Probably is though, if I go to like somewhere like Bidston, go either out there, that's it. You get all your use on that line. So I might go somewhere a bit closer to like Birkenhead North or something like that. And I might film on the Chester line. Somewhere like Rock Ferry or something like that. So hopefully you enjoy today's show. Sit back and enjoy.
My name is Simon Paul.
I'm just a regular guy with a hobby.
We're a passion for trains.
And also enjoy travelling by train.
And if anyone thinks I do these videos to make myself famous, well, I'm afraid I've got some bad news. I do these for fun.
So sit back.
Enjoy your ticket and enjoy my railway journey. Well, you can only see lights and all that, but we are arriving into, you can see a bit of platform there. Arriving into Rugeley Trent Valley.
Bye. London Midland service to Liverpool Lime Street. The next stop will be Crewe.
Go to the Merseyrail platform at Liverpool Lime Street. Just like their version of the underground. Moorfields is close with their own central.
being late. At Liverpool Central Station. Have to go through our escalator suite by the Wirral Line. Wirral Line is ahead. Norfolk Sandhills Station, and that's 507018 that's brought us here.
It was just a cat here, Birkenhead North. There we are at Birkenhead North Station on the Wirral Line. Sandhills is on the Northern Line. Just figured out how long you need at Sandhills to get all the units on that area. We can do so like in basically it's hour 45 minutes. You need to do Sandhills to get every single unit on that line during off peak. The depot. Just over that, round the corner, by that bridge. We're going to be here now to about just after 12 o'clock and then go to the Chester line. See what I can get on that line, which you need an hour and a half for to get all units. Anyway, on the Kirby branch, we're just going to bash up to Kirby and back before I do two stations on the Chester Ellesmere Port line, then back to Liverpool Lime Street from there. Approaching Kirby now, it's like Olmskirk, one platform.
services. Photo. I had a photo of this back on. This actually used to be a through platform as well. I've got about 5 minutes, so I can't film this lever though because my training's a minute before this one. Yeah, this used to be a through platform. Believe it or not. There's Northern Rail services to this is Blackburn at 12:44. Let's get a photo of this. Not too light because of okay. Has started raining as well, and then back over to the Merseyrail. There. But this and Kirby, I know, are the only two stations that have a platform like that. Right here in Ormskirk. Now we're going to take a photo of this and back on. See, now we're at Spital station. Thank you. As you can see here, we're at Ellesmere Port, our last stop of the day before we go back to Liverpool Lime Street. And down here, they've got several signals. As demonstrated here as well, the Merseyrail EMUs use this platform, Platform 1, for Liverpool Central, Lime Street Central. And the Northern here uses Platform 2 to Hesby and Warrington Bank Quay. So here, this is a double tourist station. They do get some freight trains that come through here as well, but not what I'm around here today though. Anyway, this one's leaving and I'm jumping on 508-115 to go back to Liverpool. So basically my train's here already. This is the 1734 to Birmingham, and it's the same one I got this morning at 10 past 8 to Stafford. I'm going to be on the same unit to Stafford. Don't know how the hell I'm going to eat this on a 350/2. I hate these units, only because they don't have tables in them and the gangways are just tight. Oh well, I'm going to jump on this and then leave Liverpool.
For John Lennon Airport, Runcorn, Acton Bridge, Hartford, Winsford, Crewe, Stafford, Henkridge, Wolverhampton, Coesley, and Birmingham New Street.
Now at Stafford, there's a gear that heads here behind us. That is from Liverpool, actually. You see it there departing. Just zoom in there. Just see it there, that's Liverpool. That's the pedal you saw when we left. 351 tent there. Just about to lead to Birmingham. Train now. AT55 to Euston. I'm not going to film this leaving, I'm not going to do the outro here, it's wet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back home. I have to check to see if this tick machine's working. Oh, it is working. And I'll do the outro down there. Mind you though, you can see it leaving from here. There goes 17501. 15337 Walton took Beeding. Anyway, we're going to go down Wharf Road here. Go after the car park is Wharf Road, and I'll go back home. And then I'll do the outro back at home.
Well, back at my place now, and it has been a good day at Liverpool, apart from Spital when it was raining. You can't make that up. Spital raining. Spit of rain. But no, we bashed some 507, 508 EMUs. We've also been down Sandhills on the Northern Line. Not to be confused with the London Northern Line. Apparently Liverpool have their own Northern Line. We've been down to Birkenhead North on the Wirral Line, and Ely Chester is the Wirral Line as well, but we just call it the Chester Line. Been to Spital, the Chester Line, and we also went to Ellesmere Port. Best time to do Ellesmere Port is when you got a Northern DMU there, even though it's the same bloody one. But I got a lot of units that I required because I'm still at, because I don't really focus on the Merseyrail that much, and I still needed to red pen, as people like to say. I use a green pen. The Merseyrail units that I need ticking off. In fact, if you give me a minute, let me just park that there for a sec. No, I can't park it there. I can't park it anyway, can I? Can I park it here? Nope. Oh, of course, if I move a load of this. That wasn't supposed to happen. There, if I just move you there a minute. There we go. I'll be right back. So I'll be back in a sec. Here we go. See, I use a green pen. These are all the fire rates required over the last 6 years, believe it or not. And all I need now is what's missing. I need 1507, which is 001. I need 2508s. I did get about 7 or 8 yesterday, including 507.02, which I needed. I meant today. Anyway. Now that. Sorry, the camera was reflecting. Now that's all sorted. Yes, this is unfortunately his book, shall we say. Anyway, I'm not here to promote his book. I'm just here. Yeah, I use it because I've just scribbled in it. We'll use a Platform 5 book to scribble his stuff. But no, it has been a good day in Liverpool. We also bashed the Kirby line, which was required for line clearance, and also the Ellesmere Port line. So hopefully you had a good day watching. I've had a good time, apart from Spital when it was raining. Raining with winds going whoosh. Our next trip may be somewhere up north again. Further north. But if not, I'll see you where the next one is. And you can subscribe to us on Facebook at Siren Trades. You can subscribe to us on Twitter at Siren Trades. You can subscribe to us on Facebook at Siren Paul's British Railway Journeys. If you like to dislike my videos for the hell of it, because you just want to for a laugh, it just encourages me to do a new one. So basically you can like it, you can dislike it. I'm still doing another documentary. So whether you like it or not, I'll still be around. And if you'd like to nick any of my videos and make them your own, they will be onto you like a rocket. That doesn't make sense. And if you'd like to print screen any of my photos, if you'd like to print screen my videos and like to use them as your own, then that makes you a photo thief. And that's it really, so see you on the next one, and hopefully you enjoyed it.